Then we got the call that the Rotary itself was interested in donating to the police some masks. We were delighted, ecstatic, and that we were at that point in time searching for some noble persons to come forward and you know, assist us. We've had tremendous from our central government, from the Ministry of Health, supporting our effort, because we recognize that as first responders. And I'm just telling my colleague there that we are always taught to interface and to act and to be in the face. Mm-hmm. That's what we're taught at training school. So even curfew and state of emergency are foreign to our thinking. There was some concern about camouflage and disruptive pattern masks, mm-hmm. and somebody asked about ski masks, mm-hmm. you know, the two eyes and all that. Mm-hmm. And we were adamant, no, the disruptive pattern is against the laws of Barbados, mm-hmm. and ski masks obviously has a different intent, and we are committed to ensuring that we get through this period, and that we get through this period with little disruptions in terms of social order, in terms of lawlessness, reckless behavior. So from Commissioner Griffith and the senior exec of the force, as well as the rank and file, and those who support us from a civilian perspective, telephone operators, accounts people, and we want to be really grateful to you and say thank you to the Rotary itself for this gesture, and rest assured that it can be valued, and we will ensure that it's used the way it ought to be used in this. So thank you very much, and be safe, and remember that the force is there for you.